This will be the Golden Knights' second to last significant road trip of the regular season. It starts Friday at Winnipeg. Head coach Pete DeBoer says Marc-Andre Fleury will be in net for that one, and includes an important back-to-back against Calgary and Edmonton, the two teams that sit behind the first place Knights in the Pacific Division.
All these games are really big. You know, oftentimes they can be 4-point swings, and coming down to crunch time here and making the playoff push, every point's important.
Yeah, back-to-backs are tough, especially two on the road. Just going to have to catch up on your rest, and yeah, it's obviously a big road trip.
A five-game road trip, what are you looking for from your team and out of yourself?
I think just keep on going. You know, we've had a good stretch here at home, and obviously every point matters, right? So it's still a very tight race, and you know, just in the playoff and trying to get home advantage, right?
You know, what do we won, 9 out of 10 or 10 out of 11, and we're still right in the, you know, we've got teams, you know, right behind us and right around us. So I think it's going to be like that right to the end. So you've got to take care of your business. And for us, we've had the benefit of being at home here for a couple weeks, and now we've got to go and bring that game to the road.
Back at practice Thursday for the first time since suffering a lower body injury on February 13th was forward Alex Tuck. DeBoer says he expects Tuck to play at some point during this road trip.
Yeah, according to the CDC, most viruses do not spread easily on airplanes because they say of how the air is filtered. Even so, passengers are advised to stay away from sick travelers, which is, of course, easier said than done on a packed flight. So one alternative is to keep it small.
We go down to McDonald's and get a drink and come down here and just watch the planes.
Carol Morgan is out here every day.
We wish we could be on one, but we're not.
Watching planes come and go from McCarran International Airport. And she understands the threat of coronavirus has had an impact on the travel industry.
They should take precautions, use the sanitizer, and you know, just be careful.
Just this week, both United and JetBlue Airways cut their U.S. flight schedules over concerns about the virus. While over at the Henderson Executive Terminal,
we're easier to get in and out of airports. The travel is a lot faster. It's way more convenient.
Tony Malfa of Prestige Air Group has been swamped. His fleet of four corporate planes in high demand.
You're not flying around with 147 people you don't know.
Ever since coronavirus hit the states.
A lot of our pilots are ex-medevac pilots, and they were taught a long time ago, you know, after you're done flying, you know, you go in, you wipe the cockpit down, you wipe the cabin down, you make sure everything is nice and clean for the next customer.
Malfa says the average ticket is around $500, slightly higher than a first class seat on a major commercial carrier.
They don't want to wear a mask in the airport, and they don't want to, you know, they don't want to just deal with the hassles of what's going on in the big terminal today.
As for Morgan,
would you be afraid to get on a plane right now?
It depends on where I was going.
She's content to sit and watch, hoping the coronavirus doesn't ground future flights. Now, unfortunately, we do know that will be happening effective this Monday, March 9th. Korean Air has suspended flights between Las Vegas and South Korea. Also late today, a spokesman for McCarran putting out a statement that at this time, the airport has not been advised of any need for public health screenings at McCarran. Reporting live, I'm Denise Ross for News 3. LaToya, let's go back to you in the studio.
Somebody stays in here in Las Vegas, you have to be prepared.
Shoppers continue to flock to stores for water, toilet paper, and other items after news of the first presumptive case of coronavirus in Southern Nevada.
As soon as they know it's somebody here with coronavirus, they're going crazy.
Wanda Rivera was stocking up at Sam's Club today just in case she's trapped at home.
I'm going to buy this, I'm going to buy cans of everything and other stuff to be prepared. If not, I'm going to have in the house. And I use it if nothing happened.
Victoria Williams, who shops for others, says she has had requests to purchase 150 cases of water for just one customer.
And we've noticed that stores are running out of a lot of items and having to limit what people are getting.
So what is causing this rush to shop?
What people are focused on right now is very much about the dangers that are posed by the coronavirus, either by getting sick themselves or being quarantined or isolated, even if they aren't.
Dr. Stephen Benning, an assistant professor of psychology at UNLV, says the first presumptive positive case in Las Vegas could shift people's anxiety toward the virus into fear.
They may feel as if they are working to keep themselves safe in any way possible, even if those ways don't have a lot of scientific backing.
Dr. Amy Stone says there is no information right now about whether we will see coronavirus spread in Southern Nevada.
We don't have any evidence to suggest that people who get symptoms are contagious before they show symptoms. But it's unlikely that we're going to see a massive outbreak, given what we've seen in the other United States cities.